Welcome to Microwave and Electromagnetics lecture series. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you Smith chart example for parallel stub matching in this video. So here, for impedance matching, we'll be using parallel stub and we will identify length and the position of the stub by using Smith chart. So let us have a question where you can see this is the transmission line which we have, and with this transmission line we have ZL, that is 0.3 plus j 0.5, and to provide impedance matching to this transmission line, here I am providing short circuited stub that you can see. Now see, here we will be identifying length and the position of the stub by calculation in terms of admittance. So here we have been given with ZL, so first we will identify YL. Here, then we will identify Y1, here then we will identify Y2, and this is what short circuited stub. So here we have YSC. So remember, this question is based on impedance matching, that we do it by having admittance. Now one thing that one should know, see, for impedance matching, Y1 plus Y2, that should be equals to 1, where Y1, that is admittance looking towards this side for this section of transmission line, and Y2, that is admittance of this stub by looking from this side, and if you add both, then that should be equals to 1. So I'll show you how to calculate all these parameters step by step. So here we have Smith chart, and in this Smith chart we have ZL. So we are required to place ZL, that is 0.3 plus j 0.5. now one should know, see, these are the real circles and these are imaginary circles, and in this upper imaginary circles are positive imaginary circles, and this lower imaginary circles are negative imaginary circles. Now here ZL is 0.3 plus j 0.5. so you see, now real circle that is having 0.3 like this, and imaginary circle that is having plus j 0.5 like this, so that is intersecting somewhere over here, and based on that we can have a location of ZL, and by this ZL we can make VSWR circle with respect to center. So by taking this center, make a circle through this ZL, right, that is VSWR circle. So let us make it. So now we have VSWR circle over here. Now based on VSWR circle, we can easily identify VSWR and reflection coefficient. So you see, on this axis, if you stretch a straight line, by this first axis we can have VSWR. For this case it is 4.2, and this third axis, that explains you reflection coefficient. So for this case over here, you see that is 0.62. So reflection coefficient and VSWR, that even we can calculate over here. But our agenda is to identify length and position of the stub. And as I have said earlier, we need to identify YL, Y1, YSC and Y2. Now you see, YSC is what? Short circuited admittance. Now you see, if you observe this Smith chart, then over here we have Vmin, over here we have Vmax. Vmin will happen at Zmin, and Vmax, that will happen at Zmax. When you have Vmin, at that time there will be Zmin, and you will be having Y open circuit, that one can say. And when you have Vmax, at that time there will be Zmax, and there will be YSC, means Y short circuit. So at this point there will be YSC, right? So let us consider this point as a YSC for this VSWR circle, where we have Vmax, and that is what YSC, that even one can say, right? Now let us calculate YL. So you see, YL, that is exactly opposite diametric point of ZL. So let us stretch a line from the center, for ZL and opposite line over here for YL. So this point is YL, and you see real value of this YL, that is somewhat 0.9, and imaginary value, that is somewhere over here, right? So let us mark this point, and that value exactly is 0.9 minus j 1.45. See, this is negative imaginary circle, that's why it is minus j 1.45, right? Now we have YL, and now our agenda is to identify Y1 and Y2. So to identify Y1, you see it is 1 minus JB or 1 plus JB. Now if it is 1 minus JB, then this will be plus JB. If it is 1 plus JB, then this will be minus JB. Now to get Y1, all we need is, it is intersecting at one real value. So here we need to make a circle with a unit real circle. So let us draw unit real circle. So you see this is real circle. So this is unit real circle, which is having real value, that is equals to 1, right? Now you see, when you move from YL to Y1 in this direction, this is towards the generator direction, and towards the generator direction, that is there in clockwise direction. So when you move from YL towards Y1, and when it intersects to this unit circle, at that time we will be getting Y1. So you see here, from YL to clockwise direction, we will be moving in this direction, and here intersection will happen. This is the point which is Y1 point, right? So we are willing to find intersection to unit circle from YL in clockwise direction to get Y1. Why we are moving like this? You see here we have YL, here we have Y1, and we are willing to move from YL to Y1, and this is towards the generator direction. So let us move. You see I'm moving, and here intersection is happening. So this is our Y1, and you see it is having unit magnitude and imaginary magnitude, that is somewhere over here, which is Y1, and you see that is 1 plus j 1.56, right? Now based on Y1, we can get Y2. Now you see, as I have said, Y1 plus Y2, that should be equals to 1. So Y2, that will be having opposite complex data. Here complex data is plus J 1.56. So Y2 will be minus J 1.56. You see, Y2 will be minus J 1.56. And real component of Y2 will be 0. So this is most outer circle of Smith chart, that is having unit circle, that is having real value, that is 0, and minus J 1.56, that is happening somewhere over here. So let us mark this point, right? So this is minus J 1.56. So now see, this Vmax, that is YSC, that already I have said, and now we have Y1, Y2, YL and YSC, so we can identify L1 and L2. So now you just focus about L1. L1 is a length from YL to Y1 in this direction. And in this direction means which direction? Towards the generator direction, means clockwise direction. So YL to Y1 in clockwise direction, we have L1. So you see YL to Y1, right? In clockwise direction, we have L1. So let us identify position of stub L1, that is from YL to Y1 in clockwise direction. So this is YL. So let us move towards Y1. So this is L1. You just calculate this by observing Smith chart. I have calculated that its value is 0.35 lambda. Now for length of the stub calculation, you see here we have YSC, and here we have Y2, and if you move in this direction, means this is towards the generator direction, right? Then we have length L2, so YSC is this, and Y2 is this. So from YSC to Y2 in clockwise direction, we have L2, right? So we are able to find length of stub L2 by moving from Vmax. Vmax is YSC to Y2 in clockwise direction. So see, this is YSC to Y2, and this is what a length of stub. So here it is 0.091. Here I have done mistake. It is 0.091 lambda. Remember this. You can download all these examples material from my Android application, where I have provided all this material free of cost. So my dear students, you can download many subjects material from my Android application. You just go through it